Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining the multi-protocol BGP Ethernet VPN control plane underlay deployment for VXLAN. If you like my content so far, and if you're interested in seeing more networking and telecom technologies simply explained, then please subscribe now to the channel. And when you subscribe, make sure you enable notifications like so that you'll be informed of new content. If you like this video, as always, please make sure to click that thumbs up button. So far in my series on VXLAN, we went over the various ways in which you can deploy the control plane such that VXLAN is able to find the remote VTEP on which the intended destination host resides. We took a look at various solutions, including statically configured VTEP peers, using a simple multicast underlay with a single rendezvous point, as well as using multicast with anycast IPs for redundant rendezvous points. Today, we'll be looking at the solution that uses the multi-protocol BGP Ethernet VPN or MP-BGP EVPN control plane for VXLAN. Now, how does this MP-BGP EVPN solution operate differently than previous solutions? Well, what we're actually going to create here is a topology that will dynamically share MAC addresses of hosts connected to VTEPs that belong to particular VNIs. And it is the BGP protocol that will be used to advertise and share those MAC addresses. That's why we're using multi-protocol BGP, which is essentially an extension of BGP that can advertise various types of address families. In this case, we're not advertising IPv4 or IPv6 address families, but we're advertising the layer 2 EVPN address family. In other words, MAC addresses. So the MP-BGP EVPN solution allows these devices to share information about the MAC addresses of hosts that exist on particular VTEPs. And this information is used to then populate the BGP table of the local VTEPs. Yes, that's right. The BGP table contains the MAC addresses of remote hosts that exist on the same VNI. In this way, we vastly reduce the operation of flood and learn, making the whole process more efficient. We're using BGP to populate the EVPN address family BGP table with MAC addresses we're learning from all VTEPs that include a particular VNI. Now, in order to make this work, we need to ensure that we have several different technologies up and running within this topology. First of all, these devices in the underlay, including the VTEPs, must participate in BGP. So all of these devices become BGP peers with the rules that govern how BGP peers must be deployed. But because such a topology is usually quite vast, with many peers and ultimately a very large number of MAC addresses, you will find that a root reflector is often deployed to make the topology more scalable. If you're not familiar with the BGP protocol, its peering requirements, and root reflectors, take a look at my series on BGP. You can find links in the description below to the YouTube playlist that contains all videos, as well as links to specific videos that further discuss these particular topics. Now, an MP-BGP EVPN control plane is essentially used to minimize the use of the flood and learn technique to find the MAC addresses of hosts. This, of course, involves the ARP protocol. The MP-BGP EVPN solution helps to make the use of ARP on the VXLAN topology much more efficient, making the whole topology more efficient as well. But even so, there are mechanisms other than ARP that operate on the network that still use multicast, as well as broadcast and unknown unicast traffic, and we must provision for such traffic to be able to traverse the VXLAN topology. This kind of traffic is known as bum traffic. Yep, you heard me right. Bum traffic. That's broadcast, unknown unicast, and multicast traffic. Even though we're using MP-BGP EVPN, we still need a mechanism that will transmit such traffic for use by other protocols. For example, DHCP uses broadcast to work. Routing protocols use multicast to work, and so on. So we still have to provision for such traffic to be propagated to all hosts within a particular VNI on our VXLAN topology. To do this, we keep our original multicast implementation that we looked at in previous videos to take care of this bum traffic. So even if you deploy MP-BGP EVPN, you still must simultaneously deploy a multicast underlay as well in order to ensure that bum traffic is handled correctly. So what does a communication using this method look like? Now the thing is, all of this is primarily set up to eliminate that flood and learn process. However, initially, if you turn everything on from scratch, ARP will still be flooded to all VTEPs that contain the VNI from which the originating host is sending. So here, if PC1 sends an ARP request to find the MAC address of PC2, we will still get a flood and learn operation. As described in previous videos, the multicast underlay will cause that ARP request to reach all VTEPs that contain VNI 6501. The difference, however, is that once that MAC address is learned using the flood and learn process, the VTEPs 1 and 2 inform the root reflector of the MAC addresses of PC1 and PC2. The root reflector, in turn, updates all of the rest of the VTEPs in the topology, which are configured as client BGP peers to that root reflector, of these MAC addresses. So with just one flood and learn, all VTEPs in the topology that contain VNI 6501 have learned of the MAC addresses of PC1 and PC2. Now, it's not enough that the MAC address of PC1 enters the BGP table of VTEP 1 here. We need to have that information enter the local MAC address table. Remember, when using BGP for IPv4 or IPv6, the best route that is determined by the BGP table will enter the routing table to be used for routing. A similar mechanism takes place here. In this case, using the EVPN address families, the best MAC address that exists in the BGP table will be used to populate the MAC address table. So if we were to look at the MAC address tables of all VTEPs that contain VNI 6501, we'd see these two entries, one for the MAC address of PC1 and one for the MAC address of PC2. Now here I've just placed the corresponding VTEP name, but in a real MAC address table, we'd have the actual underlay IP address that corresponds to that VTEP. So that's an introduction to the VXLAN MP-BGP EVPN underlay and a brief description of how it works. Now, as a teaser for the next video, let me just say that until now, on all my VXLAN videos, we have only been talking about layer 2. We've configured VNIs that span the whole topology, but we haven't yet seen how we can make hosts in different VNIs communicate with each other. To do that, we'll need to employ layer 3 MP-BGP EVPN mechanisms on our VXLAN topology, but I'll talk about that in my next video. For now, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.